Live now to Cam Inglis at Indooroopilly Police Station. Cam, you have some information about a boy involved in a high-profile carjacking.
Yeah, Melissa, I think we knew it was likely that this teenager had been involved, had been in trouble with the law before, but I don't think anyone could predict that he was facing such an astonishing number of charges, and he was out on bail at the time. Now, despite this, police were forced to intervene in the courts to keep him off the streets.
17 and in handcuffs.
He's under arrest at the moment, got multiple warrants out.
It's now been revealed the boy was already out on bail for 94 charges at the time, including 38 break-ins and 28 car thefts. Police re-arresting him earlier this month for stealing a car in Bulimba at knife point. But incredibly, he was given bail again, taunting police on social media.
That child has been given opportunities to rectify their behaviour.
Police left with no choice but to apply to the court and successfully get him back behind bars.
Thank goodness the Supreme Court recognised that the magistrate got it wrong.
The opposition claims the state government's got it wrong.
Today is 6 months since Anastasia Palaszczuk announced the 10-point plan to tackle the issues of youth crime and the youth crime crisis in Queensland.
We have been working on some of these reforms, and today I've announced the complete package.
But in the last 6 months across Queensland, stolen vehicles are up 12% and break and enters have climbed 10%, though the state government says it's starting to see results from new breach of bail laws.
We're seeing those early numbers. We're seeing young people charged under those new offences.
Cam Inglis, Nine News.